Hello guys. Today I will tell you a story. It's a story time video. This happened either last week or I think last week, yes, it was last week, yes. So I was with my friend. I was out. We were playing football, and we usually return late, like 11 past 11:30, 12 o'clock. You understand? And we had money on us, and we wanted to eat, so we went on a fast food restaurant. A local fast food restaurant. It's big. So, and we have some things that is called begleri. I don't know if you know it, but yeah, it's a thing with two balls and you play with your hand with a rope in the middle from the balls, just from the balls hung. And yeah. So there are some people that come in the fast food restaurant and sell them. Not illegally, but sell them. So a guy just came as we were eating, as we were ready to leave, to be more truthful. As we were ready to leave, he just came in, and we weren't interested on it, but he forced us. I mean, just like he told us how much you have, how much he asked. He told us how much he was selling. He was selling for 4 euros, and that's not cheap. I had 4 euros, but I didn't want to pay that much for it. So I told him I only have 1 euro. He said, after 3 or 4 minutes discussing it, he says, okay, you can buy it for 1 euro. And as we reached to get it, we give him the money, he give us the thing. He opens up his phone and started talking to... I don't know, he was black, so I think he was talking African or Nigerian, I don't know what language he was talking, but he was a pretty cool guy, I'm not gonna lie. Till this moment. So as we went to pay what we have eaten, we see two other guys just coming from looking at, staring at us and then leaving. And it was the moment that we was like, oh no, what are we doing? Because when we left the shop, they were waiting. I don't know if they were waiting us, but they were waiting on the corner. The corner that we turned to go to my house, because he would be sleeping here tonight. This night, not tonight. And we were like, what should we do? Should we run or should we? I don't know. So we said like, maybe we'll drink one more Coca-Cola and then we will leave. So we went back in the shop and we said, can we have one more Coca-Cola? They gave us the Coca-Cola after 20 minutes of just drinking it slowly. We went outside again and they were at the same exact spot. They haven't left. They were just staring at us right when we left. And we were like, okay, let's go. I don't think they're with us. And we started going, and as we get past them, the turn we take is an arrow. So yeah, not much space, no one will even hear you. So I don't know how, but I just looked behind, and for a reason I just wings my hair, my hand. Like, I wanted to greet someone, I don't know, greet someone. I just winged it. And this guy tried grabbing my hand, but because I was moving it, he couldn't grab it. And at this moment I realized that they wanted us. They were after us. So we started running. Without even talking, we just started running. They started running behind of us and they were talking, I don't know, their language. So at the point, and we were running like for 10 minutes straight running, our fastest. And it may not sound much to you, but it is a lot, and I'm not a fit guy, I don't have much stamina, so my lungs started burning. I'm burning, I couldn't breathe, I was just running without breathing. And yeah, I got a point to that we said we can't run anymore. If they want us, they can get us. So we stopped just to catch our breath, right? And I looked behind and they were walking fast. So we took two or three breaths and started running again. We were far from my home, so yeah. And when we started running, the guy just screamed at us, "Come back, kids." And I screamed back, "Why?" He says, "You thieves," he said. I was like, "What do you mean?" And I don't know, he just grabs a knife. They were really close, they just catch up to us, they were really close. I don't know, I didn't even see what it was, but I think it was a knife. I'm not sure. And I was like, "Oh no, 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 no. We should get out of here fast." So I grabbed my friend of the hand again and I pulled him over. I pulled him so hard that he fell down. My heart was racing because he fell down. And we were like, okay, he just went up and started running because he understood it. He knew what was happening. And to this moment, everything was okay, alright. And I remember that there was an office station nearby, policemen, like we were like, "Oh, policemen, they will save us." And the station was not close. Only thing I can say, but I thought it was close. It was 10 minutes running. And we started running without finding it. And we were getting stressed. When you get stressed, you lose stamina. So we kept running 5 minutes, 6 minutes, 7 minutes, 8 minutes, we were running for 8 minutes. Then we started walking, he grabbed me by my foot and I fell down. I literally fell down and he takes out the thing that they put drugs when they melt it. Yeah, I think it was a drug just to make me fall asleep, I don't know. And I just punch him in the face, punch him. He drops his knife and the thing, I think it's called a C-ring, I don't know. And he said, "Come here, come back, you little thief." As we start running, we ran real fast. Yeah, as I remember. So we got to the station. We told the policeman what happened, and they said, "Okay, we will search for them." The next day, I went to the gym, the same gym from the last story, and I found a kid that was in a real bad condition. And I asked him, what's wrong, what happened to you? And he said, last night, three guys chased me. They injected me with a drug, and they did what they did that he didn't even know. He told his parents, but now he did. He's okay. They didn't do anything to him. It was just a drug. Yeah. So he didn't even know what happened to him. And we were like, the same guys just chased us last night. So two police officers came from the station, from the gym, sorry, and took me and my friend from the hunt, and they said it was really serious. I was scared because I thought that it was our thing, that we would go into jail. They make us sit on a table, and they said we will ask you some questions. They asked the questions, it was typical, names, where we live, what we were doing out at night, you know. And he said, okay, we have some suspects, can you please tell us if you see the guys that chased you? And they had two of them, the other one was there. So my dad is working on now. He's working, what's it called, on the army. So yeah, he was out. He didn't work. He wasn't working that night. So he went to go. We leave the station at 12 in the morning or something like this. Yeah, and because I go to the gym in the mornings. And right as we went, played football, enjoyed the day, and his house is close to mine. So we were then home together. And as we were walking, a guy just grabs me and knocks me down. Me and my friend too. And takes out a knife, a little big knife. Like small, and he was like, my friends are in jail because of you, you will die, you will pay for it. And I just heard a voice screaming, leave the kids alone, you idiot. And this was my father. He just came and out of nowhere like an angel, and yeah, he saved us. He chased the man. I don't remember if he cut him. Then, no, he didn't, because we didn't hear anything in the news. 2 weeks passed, and we heard that one guy of the two will get released because of something he had with his family. And, of course, he didn't have a family, it was lies. And we see them both again, far away from where we were going. We just went to the mall. So we see them there at the mall, and we see them at the mall, and right when we see them at the mall, they grabbed us and said, don't talk. And I just started screaming. Eventually they caught them and took them to the prison. Got 3 years, 15 years in jail. And yeah, we risked our lives 3 times. So yes guys, this was the story. I thought you enjoy it. I hope you enjoy it. I think that it was really crazy. It was horrifying from me, enjoying for you. And yeah, the only thing I wanna say is enjoy your life. life is short and you never know what's going to happen in the next moment. This was my story and this was the video. Have a nice time, see ya, enjoy!